Have you ever wondered what those square panels on the side skirts of a T-72 or a T-90 are? Well, those are actually explosives. That may sound like a bad idea, but they're actually extremely effective against incoming projectiles, and in this video, we will see why. Those panels are also known as explosive reactive armor and is a countermeasure to the very effective high explosive anti-tank rounds, or HEAT in short, or the equally destructive HESH rounds, which stand for high explosive squash head. Before we investigate how the reactive armor prevents these projectiles from piercing through, let us investigate how these rounds work. HESH is a projectile that uses a plastic explosive that is squashed against a surface before detonating. The front of the round is filled with an inert material that prevents premature detonation of the plastic explosive. The explosive is detonated milliseconds after the impact, creating a shock wave that is transmitted through the material and causes spalling on the internal side of the vehicle. The fragments separated on the internal side travel with a supersonic velocity and are nothing short of bullets, with deadly consequences to the crew or the vehicle itself. The HEAT projectile, on the other hand, is a shaped charge explosive. The penetrating power of a HEAT round comes from the shaped charge liner and high explosive. The remaining of the missile is used for the propellant that brings the projectile to the target. Once the explosive is ignited, the metal liner collapses inside the warhead into a high-velocity superplastic jet. The high temperature and velocity of the molten metal allow it to melt through the armor. This jet is capable of penetrating steel armor to a depth of 7 or more times the diameter of the charge. This round has no explosive or incendiary effect on the target. However, the high-velocity molten metal jet carries a lot of kinetic energy that is supplied inside the armored vehicle, causing death and destruction. A popular HEAT missile in modern warfare is the Javelin missile that has been a nightmare for the Russian tanks during the invasion of Ukraine. The effectiveness of the Javelin missile is not just its penetrative power, but more importantly, the ability to hit the target from above where the armor is usually the weakest. We will leave a more detailed analysis of this weapon for another video. Now, having seen the armor penetrating mechanism of these projectiles, you can probably already envision countermeasures that could neutralize the effects of these missiles. Some very cheap solutions have been seen in this conflict, such as utilizing logs for armor or space or slat armor that cause premature detonation and drastically reduce the armor penetrating capabilities of the round. A more sophisticated solution are the rectangular blocks observed on armored vehicles that detonate upon impact. These blocks, also known as explosive reactive armor, consist of a C4 explosive sandwiched between two metal plates. When the outer metal plate is hit, the explosive is detonated, blowing the plate outwards and thus helping to scatter the molten metal jet. But how does this explosion not damage the tank? After all, it is attached to the armor itself. This is a legitimate concern and requires a careful calibration of the amount of explosive used in the reactive armor, such that it would not cause damage to the vehicle itself, but would still be powerful enough to scatter the incoming projectile. In fact, the first implementation of this system was proposed in the 1960s, but due to inadequate theoretical knowledge, too much explosive was used in the preliminary models that blew up the prototypes as well. This failure resulted in an abandonment of this type of armor until the mid-1970s, when this idea was re-explored and developed again. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, consider subscribing to our channel. Thank you and see you next time.